Hey, what's good, y'all? I'm Nunu.
And I'm Wes.
And you're watching One-on-One with Nunu.
He got that fire, can't nobody put out. Tempting to inspire everyone he around. Personal thoughts and views, celebrity interviews, traveling the world just to get you the news. He just a click away, so stay connected. The hottest YouTube personality on the net.
Hey, what's good, y'all? Welcome to another exciting episode of One-on-One with Nunu. I do have my homeboy, Wes.
How y'all doing, y'all?
One-on-One with my homeboy, Wes. We live in New York City.
Yes, indeed.
I have to say I'm having a great time
here. Are you?
I love New York.
Are you sure?
I love visiting, yes. I love visiting. It just overpopulated, but it's fine.
It's
y'all walk everywhere. And yes, because if I was in L.A., I would not walk 16 blocks. I would get in my car and drive.
are the streets like the city of Manhattan, how you can walk 16 blocks and it'd be like 10 minutes or 5 minutes?
That's crazy.
You can't do that in LA?
Unheard of down south and the LA.
So the blocks are like long blocks?
Long blocks.
Okay.
And yeah, I would drive to Walmart. I would not walk 10 blocks to Walmart.
Okay.
But I'm here in New York. I'm doing a lot of projects here, and I wanted to actually sit down with you. I want to introduce you to my viewers and to the world, because I love to see you grow, and we've been seeing each other grow.
We've been
knowing each other for a long time.
Yeah, since 2008, 2009. Yeah.
So tell us about your company, your channel, and stuff like that, and what characters do you play on the show?
Well, I created the YouTube channel A Connection TV, the network, and I call it the network because when you tune into A Connection TV, you're gonna get a lot of different types of videos. You're gonna get cartoons, you're gonna get Mona Simone, which is my younger version, if you will, of a Shanae mixed with a Madea.
Right.
You get real life commentary. I travel and I take my camera with me, just like you do when you travel. We take our cameras around. You get regular vlogs. You get B-Fam, which is another series. So I do a lot of different things on A Connection TV. So that's why I call it the network.
Right.
The most popular one, of course, is Ghetto Ratchet, Mona Simone. Everybody likes Ghetto Ratchetness. So that's the most popular. But I've been doing that for a while now, and I'm just now starting to get into hosting and doing outside events like acting and stuff like that.
Right.
It's been a long time coming, but now that I don't do my primary job anymore, I'm decided to take a break from working a regular 9-to-5. It actually allows me to do more in what I want to do, which is like acting, directing, producing, and stuff like that. So
the biggest people in the history of film and stuff like that have to be focused and try to put more attention on your real dream instead of getting sidetracked and stuff like that.
Because when I think about it, when I met you, I was working my primary job, and I've been doing that and doing this like on the side, but now I can focus on this and doing extracurricular things. So I'm excited. I'm really excited. I'm going to Miami this week, and it's gonna be live because I'm the only main blogger from our circle going this year.
So the bloggers say fuck it.
Right.
Yeah.
But that's gonna be interesting because I'm throwing a party down there, and knowing you and knowing like Kevin and everybody else, like when I see y'all out and do y'all thing, y'all are like the networkers in the group. I don't really network. I pretty much stay to myself.
Oh, I don't network too. I'm like the shyest person you ever meet.
I don't know. I don't get that.
You guys have some lick in my system, and I'm good to go. But other than that, I don't approach people. I don't do all that and stuff like that.
Well, I need to do more of that because I think if I do, it'll just broaden my horizons, which is one of the reasons why I went to Latino Oasis. I met so many people there, and I'm glad that I went. It was a very fruitful type of trip for me. So because of that, I'm going to be doing more gigs and hosting certain events and stuff like that. So my message to you guys is, if you want to get into this type of world, mm-hmm. then you have to open yourself up and become more social and network.
Social network and be, I think the most, people always ask you all the time, how do you start blogging? What should I do? You know,
right.
I always say be persistent.
Right.
And I think that you are a true living testimony of being persistent and not giving up. Cause I remember, when I came, like 2009, I came to visit you in New York. I remember you was asking, I had more subscribers than you. You was right. Like, what are you doing? I was like, I don't know. But you got on your game. You up to how many subscribers now?
It's almost 28,000 or something like that.
That's good.
Yeah.
And it's seeing how you surpassed me on, you know, for your own dreams. And my ass still had a 9-to-5, still doing this thing and shit like that. But I'm learning from you, and that's good. And I'm proud of you.
I appreciate that. Thank you.
So tell us about the feedback you've been receiving from your fans and viewers and stuff like that.
It's so crazy. I think it's like a bad thing, kind of, that I do so many different videos on my channel because I never really know what people come to my channel for. Mm-hmm. But people, they tell me that they like my regular blogs where I'm myself and I talk about real life issues, because they feel that a lot of bloggers don't do that anymore. Mm-hmm. So they come to see that, and then a lot of people like the comedy aspect.
They want to see the real shit.
Yeah.
Well, you know, something they can relate to.
Yeah. Which I just did my shower confessional video. I haven't done that in like 3 years. Right. And I've gotten so much positive feedback about that because it's relative issues that I speak about in the video. Mm-hmm. And then off the side note, you know, a lot of people like to laugh. So they come to A Connection TV because they know they're gonna laugh, whether it's watching Twan Rose twerk or whatever, or watching Mona Simone go off on a Bad Girls Club video. Right. People like to laugh, and I think when you do comedy like that, to shout out T. Pendel, T. Funk, Mr. Troy, he has a phenomenal channel, and the reason why it's phenomenal and successful is because you know what you're gonna get when you tune into his channel, and that's you're gonna laugh. He's a great comedian, so that's why I've really gotten bigger with doing the Mona videos and the Twan videos, so that people can laugh.
Do you think that it is a setback for people, comedians on YouTube, like Africano Boy and these other comedians who are doing stuff? Do you think people can't take them seriously? You think that's the reason why you have, you know, increase in viewers and viewership, because they see the comedy side and they see the most serious side of you?
I think it's like a double-edged sword, because I know it's like when you do this kind of blogging thing, you know that people want to laugh, you know that people want to do all that extracurricular stuff, but the double-edged sword part about it is because people really think Mona is real. Like, yeah, it's deep. Like, people,
you do drag shows.
They think I'm Mona all day, every day.
There's nothing wrong with it.
There really isn't. But that's not me. You know what I'm saying? Like, when I turn off the camera, I don't walk outside and I'm Mona Simone and I'm carrying on.
Right.
And a lot of people have finally gotten used to knowing that I'm Wesley and Mona. But still, like, I'd say like 65% of them think that I'm Mona Simone 24/7.
Well, you can let them believe whatever they want. If they keep watching,
right. But that's why I think it's like a double-edged sword, because when I met Africano Boy, I thought Africano Boy was just crazy. Mm-hmm. Like, his videos like 24/7. But you can't really think that. And I've learned that over the years. You can't really think that. Like, I'm dying to meet Funky Dineva and see if he's that 24/7. Because sometimes you just never know, and sometimes
he's crazy as probably.
Hey, I don't know, but I don't know. I think people need to realize that what we do, especially speaking for me, is for entertainment purposes.
Right.
It's not me all day, every day, but it's a side of me that I act and I share with you guys just so you can laugh, you know? And I'm looking forward to bringing A Connection TV on stage. That is my next biggest project. My script is finished. I sent it out to some very high profile critics. So I'm fearing and yet waiting to get their feedback on the script, and then I'm gonna start auditions and everything to be out on stage in New York. So that's like my biggest thing. I've always wanted to do that, which is the main reason why I started doing A Connection TV, was to kind of follow in Tyler Perry's footsteps.
So he's your inspiration.
Yeah, okay. Him and, well, yeah. I mean, he's a black man in Hollywood that has Buku Money, his own film company, right. And you know, he can do whatever he wants to do. Like, who wouldn't want that kind of lifestyle? You know, but him, Martin Lawrence, Will Smith, those are like black people that kind of inspired me to do what it is that I do.
So what is it like dating you? Do you find it more hard getting dates and getting to know someone when you have all these characters that's portrayed all around the world?
Yes. Once people find out about what I do, they run away. Because
I don't do that money.
Right. As an open gay man that plays a female character and a flamboyant queen, another gay man is gonna look at me and be like, yeah, you're not masculine, you're just like that. And
you motherfucking drag queen.
Yeah, I can't deal with that. They don't see the acting part of it. But I mean, I'm talking to someone now, so I'm good. Uh-huh. You know, but I don't really worry about like what people think about what I do. Like I used to, like the first year or so, I used to care about it, but now I don't give a fuck.
I think that's one of the good things I like about having a lot of YouTube friends, because we can relate to each other on so many different things, like relationship wise, trying to get our name out there, how to struggle and the pressure, you know, it's hard because you want to see your stuff succeed and at the same time you want to live normal.
Right.
So I understand, because it is hard for me sometimes to find a date and stuff like that.
It's interesting that you say that, because when I talk to someone, I used to not tell them what I did, and I would wait till they at least got to know me a little bit better. Mm-hmm. But now I don't care. I'm like, you know, I'm up there in age, so now it's like I don't have time for that. You know what I'm saying? I'm a grown ass man. And I don't have time for that. So it's like, hi, I'm Wes. And when they ask, what do you do? I say, I'm a blogger. And then from there, we go on and talk about it.
It doesn't matter. No matter how many times I try to get to know someone and they break up with me just because I wasn't honest with them of what I'm doing online, I keep doing the same thing over and over, and I'm never learning from that experience. So I'm talking to someone now and they don't know anything about me. So I already know what the outcome might be, but sometimes I have like, do I even have a chance? Do you think
Here's the question that I ask myself. Am I happy with my channel? Am I happy with what I'm showing the world? And my answer to myself is yes. So at the end of the day, if that person can't be happy about or supportive about what I'm doing, then exactly. Fuck them. Like, that's how I look at it. Because at the end of the day, a year from now, 2 years from now, if I'm really trying to be with someone, just that one person, they're gonna have to be around it and live my life, or live with me as I'm living my life, because I'm not gonna stop. Like I was just talking to the person that I'm talking to 2-3 weeks ago, and 2 weeks ago, and I told the person, because I Instagram and I tweet. Y'all should follow my Instagram and Twitter, A Connection TV. And I Instagram and tweet about everything that I go through.
Right.
So I'm not like a censor at all. Like, I talk about all my shit because I'm a personal blogger. And I think that my audience can relate. So that's why I do.
Our whole life is circled around promoting.
Right.
So we have to promote any chance we can get.
Right.
It doesn't matter if it's personal time or public time, we have to promote.
And I'm up on it. So I tweeted and I Instagrammed about something that was about what me, him, and I went through, and then he caught a case. Long story short, I told him, I said, you know, this is something that I do. I'm not gonna stop doing it because right. I'm talking to you. Like, it's you're gonna have to figure out if you're going to
accept it or not. Move right along.
You know what I'm saying? It's just, I gave him a great analogy. I'm like, how do you think comedians stay married for so long? Like, there are comedians, black comedians out there that have been married for 10 years, 16 years, and their whole career is based upon their personal life.
Right.
So, I mean, how can you, can't separate the two when dealing with me, because we're just alike in that regard, you know?
Right.
So
they think that probably you're gonna act like that in bed, or you're gonna act like that on a normal day, meeting the family and stuff like that. I do understand where they're coming from, but they're not for you then. If you
right.
don't accept them for who they are and you don't believe in their dreams and stuff like that, I think it's a waste of time.
And what I've learned, Nunu, over the years is that the truth is the truth, regardless of whether or not who knows it. Like, if I have a deep, dark secret that I don't want anybody to know, if it's the truth, it doesn't really matter who knows it, because it's the truth. Right. You have to be willing to accept the fact that you either did it, or you was about that life, or something that was involving you that you're ashamed of, it happened. Okay, but it's the truth. So it doesn't really matter who knows. God knows. It's the truth.
All right.
So don't be upset if somebody finds out about something. Like, it's like I was telling him, I'm like, I would understand if you were pissed if I was Instagramming and tweeting about a lie. Like, I was fabricating a story surrounding you. But right. It's the truth.
Right. So who mostly is likely to watch you? Males, females, what is your...
Females.
Females.
My ratio is 60-40, last time I checked.
Right. What do you think females is like about you? Other than Mona, of course.
Yeah.
The man, the Wesley side. Do they like the muscles, do they like the body, sex appeal?
It's funny because a lot of people, when I'm myself, they're like, what? You're not gay. Oh my God, I can't believe it. Oh my God, you're so... And I think what people... Well, I don't think I know. What people gravitate toward most about me, because they've told me, that's why I know, is they feel that I'm authentic, I'm real, and I give them me when I'm me all the time.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I don't sugarcoat anything. It is what it is. And I think that's what the females love the most. A lot of the gays tell me that they love Twan Rose the right. most, and they want Twan Rose to come back. Mm. So I'm like, right?
Cause y'all know.
I just don't understand why people like that so much, but they do. So,
right.
It is what it is.
They don't favor society. Don't favor the, you know, gays people and feminine people, but they love to watch them.
Right.
Laugh at them or laugh with them. I don't know.
Right.
That's,
right.
That's what people like.
And that's the interesting part of it. And that's another reason why I branched into A Connection TV, adopting similar connections despite our differences, because we can all adopt similar connections right. despite our differences, you know? So, but I love the people that watch. I love the commentary. I love the support. And I really do appreciate it. So keep watching and keep right. supporting.
So where can my viewers find your...
Everything is A Connection TV. You can Google me, baby. You can Google A Connection TV, and mad stuff will pop up. The Instagram, Twitter, and YouTube is A Connection TV. Letter A, the word connection, and then the word TV.
So we're doing a collab together. So you guys should subscribe and check all the videos out. I have a link below of the comedy skit that we did, and I hope you guys like it. I hope you guys like Wesley. And I do want to thank you so much for having the time out.
This is the first time I've been, we've done a one-on-one, right? This is the first time?
Yeah.
After all this
goddamn time. I don't do a lot of one-on-ones with
all this goddamn time. You know, I thought it was because I wasn't a celebrity, you know. He had Karamo on. You had mad other people. Didn't you interview Candy Boris?
Mm-hmm.
Yep, see, he dealt with celebrities.
You know what?
Mm-hmm.
I had to realize, you know what, I do have to, you know, have to start somewhere. You know, I can't just always say I want a celebrity on the show. I gotta have someone in the community or someone who I see doing stuff, you know, doing stuff is going somewhere. So mm-hmm. And plus, you're my brother. So mm-hmm.
Yeah, I've known this boy for a long time.
Yeah.
I opened up my house to his ass without even knowing his ass. Baby, I didn't even know who the hell he was. I just knew he was a blogger.
I slept on that couch. I sure did.
I know he was a blogger, and that's where we had our connection. And it's, I think the biggest, the greatest thing about doing this is that there's a clique of us that do it. And out of everybody, mm-hmm. I know there's some runs and riffs amongst some of the crew, but out
some
of everybody,
don't get along. Some of us do.
I get along with everybody. I'm not a bad seed in the.
I get along with everybody too.
But I just like the fact that it's a clique of us. I really do. It's like work, you know. Right. When you go to work and you have all your other coworkers, it's right. just like that. YouTube is just like that for us.
So. Exactly. So you're going to Sizzle. I'm going to DC Pride. Yeah, so I know there's a lot of reviews that's gonna be uploaded.
It's gonna be mad videos, son.
Yeah,
like mad videos, like,
cause I know you go in. I'm like, another goddamn motherfucker.
It's gonna be.
How many parts do you got a motherfucker have?
It's gonna probably be like 10 videos from this, probably.
Well, I'll just scan through them.
Yeah, cause I'm gonna be doing a lot of interviews, and a lot of my party is gonna get a lot of coverage. I'm just gonna be doing a lot. I'm gonna go ham. So. Definitely tune in and watch.
So tune in, y'all. Comment and subscribe to this video. Like, thumbs up. and tell me what you think about Wes. Comment down. Do you think he's sexy? Do you think he's not sexy? Do you think...
What you need to do is he need to put my I don't give a fuck video below this video right here, because I really don't give a fuck. This year, it's about not caring about anything. Like, really. Like, I've been through a lot in 2012, and everybody goes through a lot, but... I just realized that here today, going tomorrow, don't give a fuck about what people think about you. As long as you doing what you want to do and living your life the way you want to live your life, fuck everybody and everything else. You know what I'm saying? Just be good to people so they can give you that good energy back and just live your life. That's it.
Live your motherfucking life, y'all.
Yes, y'all.
You heard it first. Here on 101 with Newton. Thank you guys so much for watching. I love you guys so much. Thank you for all the love and support. There's a lot more videos coming up. I'm doing a lot of interviews here in New York. I'm going to D.C., Chicago, and Detroit for a...
Traveling fool.
Yes. Because when I'm on the East Coast, I got this travel. Because when I'm on the West Coast, I'm just on the West Coast at the beach. Yes.
Getting your life.
Yes.
That's what's up, though.
So, that's it.
This week's music has been provided by... Comment and subscribe. For bios, pictures, and other shows with Nunu, just visit yourboynunu.com.